Hello dear students, today's topic of lecture is power supply. You might have seen in many applications it requires power supply. This power supply actually gives the electrical power for electrical circuits in the form of voltage and current. This power supply is of two type. One is called as AC power supply. This AC power supply is used for domestic and industrial applications in worldwide. All the electrical devices and appliances like fridge, air conditioner, fan, motor pump, light bulbs, electric irons, electric geysers, induction, etc., they work on AC power supply. In India, the domestic power supply is of 230 volt and the current rating is 5 ampere. This power supply has a frequency of 50 hertz. The AC supply is very simple to generate and can be distributed to various places with the help of transmission lines. The strength of AC power supply can be easily increased or decreased with the help of transformer. There are two types of transformer. With the help of them, we can either increase or decrease the voltage. So this AC power supply, it can be easily converted into DC with some circuits. Now the second type is DC power supply. The DC power supply, it is generated mostly using the cells or batteries. But one of the convenient way to convert a DC or to get a DC is to convert it from AC. For this, it will uses a circuit which is called as rectifier. This rectifier is a device that takes AC line voltage as the input and gives steady DC at the output voltage. Along with the rectifier, some more circuits are required to construct a DC power supply. Now let us see what is the need of regulated power supply. All the modern electronic devices, they are designed and fabricated using semiconductor ICs. These ICs dissipate very less power. ICs consist of smaller semiconductor components. Due to small rise, there is an excessive heat in the components. This heat may damage the IC. Therefore, to increase the life of ICs, ultimately the devices require a regulated power supply. So, this power supply should give a constant voltage without less dissipation of power. So, this is the need of regulated power supplies. Now, this regulated power supplies comprise of many circuits, in which one of the circuit which is called as rectifier is an essential part, because this rectifier converts AC voltage into DC. So rectifier, it is an electronic circuit that converts bidirectional current into unidirectional current. The main component is the diode which is used in rectifier. This diode conducts only in one direction when they are in forward bias mode. Hence, it is the main rectifying element used in rectifier. The power supply distributed by the power companies is AC, and all the electronic equipments works only on DC power. Therefore, to create DC, it is convenient to convert it from AC. So here it is the need to convert AC into DC with the help of rectifier. The high voltage AC is not required by all the electronic equipment, hence the voltage should be lower down, and this is done with the step down transformer. So transformer is also an essential part of power supply. The transformer has following advantages, that the AC input voltage can be stepped up or stepped down easily as our need. Second thing, it saves the power. Third thing, the transformer isolates the mains AC power with the load circuit. These rectifiers, they are mostly classified into two types. One of them is called as half-wave rectifier and second is called as full-wave rectifier. Now what is mean by what half-wave rectifier? In half-wave rectifier, the output current flows only for half cycle of the input AC. While in full wave rectifier, the output current flows for both the half cycles in same direction. This full wave rectifier, it is again classified into two types. Full wave rectifier using a center type transformer and full wave rectifier using bridge type connection. Today we will discuss regarding the other type of rectifier, that is full wave rectifier. Before starting the topic, let us recall the half wave rectifier. In half wave rectifier, the output current flows only for half wave cycle. At the output, only half wave is obtained. Hence, it is called as half wave rectifier. This rectifier is connected at the secondary of step down transformer. AC mains supply of 230 volt is connected at the primary. During one of the half cycle, the diode in the rectifier circuit conduct and the current flows only for one half cycle. So in this way, the bidirectional current is converted into unidirectional using the rectifier. Thus, AC voltage is converted into DC. So this rectifier is used for converting AC into DC. Today we will try to understand full wave rectifier with center tap transformer. For this, we must understand what is the meaning of center tap transformer. We are now better in knowing the transformer and its working. These transformers are used to step up or step down the voltages. Transformers are constructed using the coils. These coils are wound on the core. There are two types of coils. One of the coil to which the input voltage is connected is called as primary coil, and where the output is connected, that coil is called as secondary coil. Both the coils are wounded on the same core. So when AC voltage is applied to the input primary coil, it will generate the magnetic flux. This magnetic flux is linked with the secondary coil, and due to which the secondary coil will generate the electromotive force, and this electromotive force will be available in the form of voltage at the secondary winding. Now back to center tap transformer. We know that there are two types of coils wound on the same core in the transformer. The number of turns, if they are equally divided at the secondary and a one terminal it is connected in the middle of the coil, that connection is called as tapping. This tapping is at the center of the coil, so that is why this kind of transformer is called as center tap transformer. In the diagram you can see, in this type of a special type of transformer, there are three tappings at the secondary. The tapping at the center is at ground potential, that means the voltage at this point will be 0 volt, while other two tappings provides equal and opposite voltage. So this type of transformer, it is used to construct a full wave rectifier. So we name it as a full wave rectifier using center tap transformer. Let us see the diagram of full wave rectifier using center tap transformer. You can see the secondary coil is divided into two parts, upper coil and the lower coil. We have used two half wave rectifiers, each connected to one of the winding of secondary coil, and the output is taken between the diodes. Anodes are connected common, that point and the center tap point, that is ground point, and load resistance will be connected between these two terminals. We can say that it is the combination of two half wave rectifiers applied parallelly to loads. This circuit is works like two back to back half wave rectifier. Suppose upper coil's terminal point is A. Let this A point is positive with respect to point B. During the positive half cycle of secondary AC voltage, upper half of secondary windings, the diode D1, it is connected here. Now this diode will be forward biased due to the positive half cycle, while with respect to B, you can see that B point will be negative with respect to point A. So due to which the diode D2 will be reverse biased. So the current will be flowing through diode D1 and load resistance RL as shown in the figure. Whole positive half cycle will be conducted through diode D1 only to load resistance. Hence, positive half cycle will appear at the output. Now, in the next half, during the negative half cycle of secondary AC voltage at the lower half of secondary windings, the diode D1, that is the diode D1 connected at point A, will be reverse biased, while as that of point B will be positive. So here the diode D2 is in forward bias mode. So all the current will flow through diode D2 and load resistance. Here the current direction will be from B to A. The current will start from point B and it will enters to diode D2 and flows to ground terminal through resistance RL. In this way, during the both half cycles of AC input voltage, the output is getting in the same direction. Load resistance, you can see the current through load resistance during the both half cycle is same. So the direction of current for both half cycle is same. Hence the bidirectional AC current, it is converted into unidirectional current, and this current we know that it is called as DC current. The average value of output of DC voltage can be calculated as V average equal to VDC equal to twice VP by pi. Now this is the formula to calculate the DC voltage at the output. For example, if transformer's secondary voltage is of 10 volt, then maximum secondary voltage can be calculated as VP equal to VRMS into root 2. Now we know that the secondary voltage at the output is the root mean square value. This value must be converted into peak value or maximum value. For this, we will use the formula VRMS into root 2. If 10 volt is the secondary voltage, then it will be multiplied by root 2. The output will be 14.14 volt. So maximum voltage at the secondary, peak voltage at the secondary will be 14.40 volt. Calculating VDC, if you put the value of VP in the above formula, that is VDC equal to twice VP by pi, it will be calculated as 9.5 volt. Because of center tap, each diode gets only the half voltage of 14.14 volt, that is 4.5 volt. From the wave diagram, you can see how this rectified output is appearing. During the positive half cycle, diode D1 is conducting, so we will get full half cycle at the output. During the negative half cycle, the second diode D2, it is conducting, so we are getting another half cycle, and the direction of current through the load resistance is same in both half cycles. That is why only positive half cycles are getting at the output. So from the output, both the half cycles are conducted and getting at the output. That is why this rectifier is called as full wave rectifier. Hope you have understand the working of full wave rectifier using center tap transformer. Thank you.